evil exists, and evil cannot be negotiated with. Evil must be eradicated. It must be wiped out. To take a moment and just take a little closer look at the reality of Hamas. Who is Hamas? Where did they come from? What are their agendas? What is it that they're really fighting for? And so these are 8 quick facts about Hamas. This is certainly not exhaustive or even extensive, but this is just 8 little facts for you to begin to understand more what Israel is dealing with when Israel deals with Hamas, who is right there on their border. Number one, Hamas is a jihadist fundamentalist movement, which literally means Islamic resistance movement. Hamas is an acronym. Translated, it means Islamic resistance movement. And what I want to say is this: they are committed to the restoration of the caliphate. If you don't know that word, get educated on it. The caliphate is a restoration going back to the golden age of Islam, where Muslim law, Sharia law, rules the territory. And if you are a Jew or a Christian or a Hindu, if you are allowed to live, you live as a dhimmi. You live under dhimmitude. You are a second-class citizen. Everything is ruled by Sharia law. So that's who Hamas is. They are not freedom fighters. They're not working for the establishment of a modern, peaceful, human rights Palestinian state. They are Islamic extremists dedicated to a global caliphate. Number two, Hamas absolutely refuses any room whatsoever for Israel. In the words of the Hamas charter, it says Hamas believes that no part of the land of Palestine shall be compromised or conceded, no matter how long the occupation lasts. Hamas rejects any alternative to the full and complete liberation of Palestine from the river to the sea. And this is the idiotic chant that these students are taking up on college and university campuses, not having a clue what it means. This is a call for genocide, for the extermination of the state of Israel. So Hamas is not here to negotiate a two-state solution or work towards any kind of peaceful coexistence. Number three, the watchdog group Freedom House found in a 2020 study that the Hamas-controlled government has absolutely no effective independent mechanisms for ensuring transparency in its reporting. Why is this important? Because these facts, so-called, that we get from how many people are killed in this battle? How many people died in this situation? These are all filtered through Hamas governmental agencies. These governmental agencies do not operate in any way that a Western mind understands, where there's checks and balances and a free press and a Freedom of Information Act, etc. Folks, we don't understand. None of that operates. These are tyrants. These are dictators. These are despots. And so when they give facts, they can make up whatever fact suits them at the moment. There is zero accountability. There is zero checks and balances that exist within the tyranny of Hamas. Number four, Hamas was one of the very first organizations to use suicide bombing, beginning in April 1993, right when the Oslo Accords were starting to take form and there seemed that there could be the possibility of peace on the horizon. Hamas immediately began to work against Fatah, then headed by Yasser Arafat, and started the systematic suicide bombing campaign that has terrorized really the whole world since then. They were one of the early developers. Can you imagine the kind of ideology, the kind of brainwashing that has to exist for them to be able to produce not just one, not just two, but dozens and dozens of suicide bombers that have taken place since 1993. Number five, since Hamas took control of the Gaza Strip, There have been many reports, including a 26-page report by Human Rights Watch, which is not known as a right-wing organization. And these reports detail the systematic arrest, abduction, beating, torture, and killing of Palestinians who are critical of Hamas. Did you hear that? Report after report, including 26 pages by the Human Rights Watch, that Hamas regularly, systematically arrests, abducts, beats, tortures, and kills Palestinians who are critical of Hamas, accusing them of being collaborators with Israel. We are dealing with barbarians. We are dealing with people who do not know the rule of law, do not know freedom of the press, do not know checks and balances, do not know accountability. It is the rule of might, the rule of the gun and the knife and the sword. Number six, according to the Independent Commission for Human Rights, unidentified gunmen in masks beat and deliberately inflicted bullet wounds to the legs of at least 49 Palestinian political rivals in 1 month. Get this picture. They will hold sham elections and they'll hold up these elections and say that there's democratic process going on. But here within 1 month, 49 Palestinians who were trying to stand against Hamas, trying to run against Hamas, were inflicted with bullet wounds in their legs. How much actual free process do you think is happening in that part of our world? Folks, we have to understand what we are dealing with here. These are people. After 10/7, people said, well, these are animals. And I hesitate to say that because there are not animals who act this way in the animal world. These are not animals. These are people who are thoroughly evil. Their minds have been given over to an evil that knows no bounds. Number seven, according to the U.S. State Department, Iran funds Hamas and other jihadist groups to the tune of $100 million annually. $100 million just from Iran. This is a well-funded group, and they use this money to run these indoctrination camps. They set up schools, they set up camps, they set up social relief centers. They welcome in people who are in dire straits because the territory is a mess. They've got nowhere else to turn, and it becomes an indoctrination center that then produces the suicide bombers that they instituted in 1993. We have an absolute cycle going on that is producing this violent extremism. Finally, number eight, Hamas has diverted tens of millions of dollars earmarked as humanitarian aid for the Palestinians and brought it for its own use. And folks, we have proof of this even through Google Maps and the aerial footage that you're seeing during the 10/7 war. The trucks go in. Hamas surrounds the trucks and all of the aid is stolen by Hamas. And now, if you're going to eat, if you're going to have medicine, if you're going to basically exist within Gaza, you're going to have to do it through Hamas. Here's just a few of the quick facts of what we are dealing with. Folks, I'm sorry to say this. Evil exists. And evil cannot be negotiated with. Evil must be eradicated. It must be wiped out. Gold in my ear said, how do you negotiate with people whose only idea is to come and kill you? Until we understand the reality on the ground of what we are dealing with, what Israel is dealing with, when they're talking about eradicating Hamas, we're not going to understand the reality of the facts on the ground. A ceasefire does nothing but allow Hamas another 6 months, another 12 months, another 18 months to get another 20 million, 40 million, 60 million from Iran to rebuild their weapons and to prepare another 10-7. Hamas must be destroyed.